Welcome back to Let's Play Stasis Blind. I am the RPG chick. Amethyst Lunatari. Is it through this way? I wasn't able to figure out anything else in the security office, what to do with those cameras and stuff. So I guess we'll just go to this door that's been opened by our lovely friend. Hope we don't get violently killed by whatever we saw walking around.
Warning.
Nearby.
Serotonin levels are abnormal.
You sound spooky as hell. I'm sure that doesn't help. Entertainment block. Tram station B. What does it say? Sleep blocks. Mess hall. Or mess hallie. That's tram station A. Okay. The constant flickering of its lights does not add to your confidence in this elevator. No kidding. Anything else to see here? Dead tree. With no systems or staff paying it attention, this once proud tree has withered and faded. The quartet of monitors face you with a blank stare. Oh, something. Dead plants. Once intended to brighten up the room, the shrubbery is now bone dry and the leaves are flaking. This is the security panel for the entrance to Tram Station B. Tram Station B door must have a faulty seal. A cloud of acrid gas hangs near the floor, leaking from the room beyond. Okay, so we're going to have to turn off the gas. We saw that. It's just that's not available to us. With the, is it atmospheric controls, I believe, in the security office? But all we had was a motion thing. So I'll figure out what to do with that. I'm intrigued by the music. Anything else to see? Guess not. Entertainment block door. The scuffing on the floor in front of this door indicates that it has seen frequent use. Yeah, people like entertainment. Alright. The music is beckoning us. We're not gonna be able to get in there though, are we?
Scratch marks. Something was trying to get in.
Well, the other side of that glass pane that the thing crashed through came from where? Was it in the entertainment area? He's just gonna say the same thing. Oh, he's just gonna do that. Alright, let's try the sleep blocks A through F in mess hall then. Before heading to the tram station, if we can get in here, I can't even tell. Oh, that's dark. That's dark. Very dark. Oh! Those are the loudest lights I have ever heard. Blood. Alright. Let's go in here. What am I hearing? Sleeping cot. Tranquil environments imagery. Sleeping cot. This sleeping cot has been wrenched away from the wall, either by the damage done to the floor or the power of the root growths themselves. We have roots going crazy. From somewhere under the floor grating, steam wafts constantly upward, though it's more benign than the gas in the room. Same. Organic growth. At the thickest sections of tangled growth, bulbous knots form a shape eerily close to that of a human body. As you listen, you can hear the rasp of labored breathing. Okay, this thing's alive. Tranquil environment imagery. These artificial scenes of natural environments will soon be covered by the unnatural, but very real growths entangling this room. Sweat and mildew wafts off the unwashed linen. A brown and suspicious stain stands out on the otherwise crisp sheets. Torn up floor grating. Flaps of industrial grating have been pushed upward from below, rumpled like a discarded memo. The guts of the level below lie exposed. Well, there's a PDA over here. Oh, it's two of them. The root-like growths have become affixed to the wall here in a clustered braid. Freaky stuff. Freaky stuff. Let's check out this PDA first, then. It's not as close to the thing. Isabella Spaulding, April 12th. Another long day in hydroponics. What's this say? Laundry day on Monday? Talk to something regarding... Another long day in hydroponics. I planted carrots today. This place seriously sucks, but I figured the longer I work for Kane Corp, the sooner they'll be able to replace this defective uterus of mine. Oh, really? May 1st. Harry is protective, and not in a cute way. I makes me feel a little uncomfortable. His attempts to protect my honor, his words, whenever Grant even looks at me, are unnervingly familiar, just like my ex-husband used to be. I'm not ready for another round of that bullshit. Oh no. Don't let that slide. Half of the ship has been on lockdown, May 25th. For 2 weeks. Apparently some new scientists boarded today, so maybe they'll be able to... Maybe they'll be able to resolve the issue. But what do I know? I make vegetables reproduce for a living. That's one way of putting it. June 20th. I have to admit, Harry's whole stalker thing can be great sometimes. He's growing herbs for me so that I can make tea. With all of this new security bullshit, I wouldn't dare use company resources personally like that. I'm pretending to like Grant just a little bit. I don't, but it keeps Harry on his toes. Trying to play him. That's a dangerous game. September 23rd. Harry opted to stay on the Groomlake for another round. He was eligible to leave at the shift change, but he chose to stay. Gee, I wonder why he'd do that. He's a grown man, for goodness sake, but he's acting like a lovesick teen. He needs to stop calling me Belle, though. It's Isabella, like the Queen of Spain. It's quite, you're a queen. Don't forget it. She's probably dead, though. November 1st. I spoke way too soon. I came into Hydra today to find everything coated in this strange fungus. Harry actually had a pretty good idea. What if we fought the fungus with genetically enhanced super mushrooms? What? Oh, I skipped something. I skipped October 30th. I keep hearing chatter about a fungal growth spreading all over Groomlake. Let's hope it doesn't get here to hydroponics. I'd be devastated if anything happened to my precious celery. Alright, so then... Spoke way too soon. Here it is. I messed up. Read that out of order. November 14th. Nope, crossbreeding mushrooms did not improve things. Seriously, tried that? Hopefully the emergency rations will get here soon. Unless people want to eat the portobellos from hell, that is. This shit is about to get dangerous. December 19th. People have been beaten up. Some are even dead. We've seen a lockdown before, but it wasn't a mass panic like this. Will it be over soon? Or ever? Harry told me to stay in the sleeping block because it could be dangerous outside. You know, I have taken care of myself for 28 years without help from Harry. I think I can handle myself. Did you handle yourself? December 24th. I'm not going to spend the final days of my life playing the helpless female, and I'm not going to cling to Harry, even if he's the last human being I'll ever see. He can't expect anything from me. Guess she's dead now. So I've got this other PDA, which is very close to this stuff. Let's see if you get attacked. took me 2 clicks to... Shelby Isaacson. March 19th. I couldn't even be bothered to get out of bed today. Nobody came asking questions, though, so that works. March 30th. Sometimes when I first wake up, I wait as long as possible to say my first word of the day. Then that word serves as a prediction of how shitty that day is going to be. Naturally, Isabella woke me up by asking if I'd rather bleep Grant or Harry. I thought she was going to be some kind of feminist who didn't need a man. Hypocrite. To answer the question, I'd need to do a bit of research. Harry will suffice for that. Okay. May 14th. I guess I'm obligated to write about the ship lockdown, since it's all life-threatening or something. I don't know why we even carry these PDAs. Seriously, I will never go back and read this shit. Ironic. So all the way to August 5th. The Groomlake got a 300% funding increase. Oh, the date's on there. The date wasn't on the others, was it? I'm pretty sure the date was not on the others. Grant's gay, huh? Okay. The Groomlake got a 300% funding increase, and I have a feeling we're doing some more shady bullshit with it. Welcome aboard the Groomlake, where as far as the universe is concerned, you don't exist. And as far as the board is concerned, you don't exist. Nothing actually exists. Humanity's gonna flip shit when they finally figure that out. October 29th. So, Grant's gay. I knew I had seen him checking Harry out. Lips are sealed. November 2nd. It's going to be a long, painful death if we don't get those rations soon. I might have to start murdering and eating my blockmates. I'll start with Grant because he's got the most meat on him. Harry is last because I'm no hurry to put my mouth on that again. Ugh. November 10th. Hey, someone's making some booze. Humanity has truly reached the apex of engineering. Space moonshine. It brings a smile to my eye and a tear to my heart. Get me some. November 11th. Taste, 0 out of 10. Effectiveness, 10 out of 10. This stuff has to be at least 120 proof. Had to do something I totally don't regret to get it, and it was worth it. November 23rd. Liquor supply is running low. Food supply is high. I'm disappointed. Here I was thinking I'd be enjoying moonshine marinated leg of crant this evening. Disappointing. At least I didn't starve. December 19th. On the one hand, something exciting happened. On the other hand, we're probably going to die or something. I have no regrets. Not even that thing I did to get the moonshine. Last entry, December 25th. Yes, things seem to come to a head around Christmas, don't they? I've been thinking about it over the last couple of days, and I sincerely can't think of anything I regret. Not hooking up with Harry, not pursuing music instead of physics, nothing. It was all part of what made my life mine. Life carries on, so no matter what, so I guess it's best to just be satisfied with what little I did accomplish. The universe swallows you atom by atom eventually. You know, I'm proud of how far those atoms made it, from when they first got together to form Shelby Isaacson to where they are now. Done with that. What happens if I go over here with this stuff? Ugh. Alright. All the PDAs or anything? Because I almost didn't see those. But they're pretty sparkly and twinkly, so I guess I'd see another. Yeah, those are the noisiest lights I've ever heard. You can't just turn on like normal lights. And that was a jump scare thing. It was cheap.
Mother had a lung that was covered
Hello?
In fat.
What?
Father had a tongue that was also black.
Is anyone there?
They didn't care for us. We didn't care for them. And so it happened again and again. Skin like a crocodile and eyes like sin. The orgy consumed them from within.
Is that a recording? Weird around here. sleeping cot. Okay, you can tell from the uneven placement of the sleeping cots that some force has scattered them from their original positions. The scattered cots would offer a restful solitude if it weren't for the human innards that lie between them. Yeah, that's good detail. Old blood is flaking off this locker, exposing the remarkably shiny surface below. On closer examination, the blood has congealed to form a paste that is smeared over a once personal locker. So we can't even try to open these. These lockers have been lacerated with the deep red blood of the people who were killed here. Breathtaking backgrounds for people who will now never see them again. Dead body. Another gruesome victim of the indiscriminate slaughter. This one has a strangely wistful look on his face, as if it were imagining an escape into the cheery landscape on the walls.
Failure. Integrity compromised and failed passive systems.
Yeah, compromised. Yep. Alright, I guess we'll check this out. And the other body?
Poor bastard. Looks like he didn't even manage to get out of his bunk.
Well, it's Grant. He's the gay one. April 24th. You know what's worse than being a janitor? Being a space janitor. Haha. You ever play Space Quest? The shit I literally have to put up with is unbelievable. I mean it. My job is to control the recycling of methane expulsion from human waste. Shitty is an understatement. Plus, I can barely understand my coworker. I think he's Polish, but he only speaks Spanish. What? June 20th. Isabella's been talking to me. I hope she doesn't have any ideas. I'm really not into that. Even if she was a guy, she's just so difficult to deal with. I think she purposely leaves some shadow of a doubt that she might have some feelings for Harry, just so that he'll hang around. The poor guy is obsessed. It's creepy. But it's also the teeniest bit sweet. Yeah, that's right. He kind of might have some kind of crush on... or might have had some kind of crush on, Harry. June 29th. I think Jupiter is finally done growing. She was such a cute little kitten. Now she's big and doesn't cuddle anymore. Harry's allergic. He thinks that I keep Jupiter around just to mess with him. Really, I don't. She gets in the way sometimes, but she's the only living thing that really understands me. I love that little kitten. Big kitten. July 2nd. What am I thinking? Isabella smacked Harry straight across the face today. I think he called her a pet name to her face. I would have been flattered. Poor guy. August 11th. Everything is so uneventful around here. Maybe that's a good thing? I've been trying to talk to Isabella to see if she's interested in Harry. I don't think so, but I want to make sure. It would help me sleep a little better. Oh, so I got some kind of love triangle, but Isabella doesn't want anyone. October 8th. Interdepartmental pool to win 64 days of leave? What a joke. Kitchen security and maintenance aren't even eligible when they're the ones that keep the ship running. Oh, wait. I guess that makes sense. That's sad. October 29th. This fungus shit is everywhere. It's already in the methane collection plant. Shelby's such a cow. She says she hopes it gives me cancer. What? But that way I could start over with new organs, courtesy of Kane Corp, of course. I told her there was only one organ I really wanted, but that Harry was too busy following Isabella. Shelby said, oh, it all makes sense now. You go, girl. But I'm not a girl. Could have been worse. I just hope she can keep a secret. I don't want everyone involved in my business. Okay. So does she say that she hopes it gives him cancer so that he can start off with new organs, courtesy of Kane Corp? Or did she just say she hopes that it gives me cancer and then that's his thought after that? Because if it's the latter, that's really nasty. It's nasty in any case, but I guess she's kidding, but... November 13th. The mushroom plant that hydroponics came up with is not working. If anything, it's made life in the plant just a little more grueling. November 19th. People have been complaining to me about weird smells coming from the vents. I swear it's not the plant. I can smell it too. November 22nd. Emergency rations. I snuck some food to Jupiter first. She was acting a little loopy. I noticed just today that Harry has the most adorable way of stuffing his face. He always inspects whatever he's about to eat before he takes a bite, then shoves as much in his mouth as he can. Ah, the simple things. December 18th. Power's out in places around the ship. Hopefully the plant isn't next. That sure wouldn't end well. November 19th. Sorry, December 19th. I haven't seen Jupiter since the tremors. I can only make assumptions. Oh god, I hope she's safe. I don't want Harry to get hurt in all of this either. He's such a little guy. Somebody's stuck in a locker? Do you mind? I've been following Isabella around to get closer to Harry and make sure he's okay. I don't know what's going on, but suddenly it doesn't matter whether or not he could ever care about me. December 22nd. Those guys who went to work on Station B haven't come back yet. I've been trying to sleep as much as I can now so I can stay on my toes when everything goes to hell. I've cried a little as well, partly because of Jupiter and partly for reasons I don't understand. December 24th. I don't want to burden Harry by telling him about how I feel. I know it will just confuse and upset him. I'm really hopeful that we'll all make it out of here, but Shelby's pessimism is contagious. I don't know. Will I ever have another chance to open my heart to someone? I'll have to hope so. I just can't tell Harry. I guess you never did. This corpse has been savaged. Its leg is nothing more than tended, strapped bone. Does Harry?
I'll never get used to this.
It's Harry. I know we always have to click twice. Is he won an engraved invitation or something? Or he just really doesn't want to check it out. So Harry, this is bound to be interesting. May 1st. Belle looks like she's angry or something. Wait, what? Look at that. That's a bug. You know, I'm clicking on this, May 1st. Maybe that's the entire entry? I think it's a bug. Belle looks like she's angry or something. May 2nd. Belle says she's fine. But I'm going to keep an eye on her. Yeah, so I hit next, right? May 3rd. I had a nightmare that Belle killed herself, so I checked on her just to be sure. I hope I didn't wake her. Grant wouldn't have checked on her. That dick doesn't know how to care for a lady. Not a lady like Belle. He's creepy. So if I hit back, it just goes back. So I can only hit next. I can't hit back to go back through messages. You have to go... Yeah, alright. Trying to get to that first entry, but apparently I can't, or there's nothing else to it. June 17th. I sure hope nobody catches me growing these herbs. Space is so empty and cold, and Belle seems like she needs the comfort. I don't care if I get caught, but if I did get caught, Belle would know that I'd truly do anything for her. July 4th. Belle seems super frustrated today. I stopped asking her what was wrong because she got really mad at me the other day when I did that. I feel like I'm making her angrier every time I speak to her. She's upset and I can't do anything about it. She's only upset because of you. July 5th. She spoke to me today. I'm so glad everything is okay. I lost so much sleep over her last night. If she only knew, she'd feel so special. It didn't work that way. September 4th. Grant keeps bringing his goddamn cat into the sleeping block. I'm allergic and he knows it. I shouldn't need a shot of epinephrine every time I go to bed. He thinks he's a badass because he managed to sneak a cat on board. Belle probably thinks he's so cool. Why can't she see that he's a total dick? December 23rd. I decide to stay in the Groomlake so I can be with Belle. I don't like it here, but I love her. Yes, that's true. She was right about that. October 24th. Some guy in engineering says there's a fungus on a ship. I wonder if it's poisonous. If it is, I bet I could hijack a lifeboat to fly Belle home. So is that what he called her? Belle? And then she slapped him? Or was there something worse? November 1st. The fungi is all over in hydroponics. I have an idea, though. What if we engineer another invasive fungus to take out the alien one? I honestly don't think it'll work. I suggested it as a joke at first, but Belle thought it was a great idea, so now we have to do it. December 19th. I wish I could go back, too. November 1st, so this is a while later. December 19th. Grant's been following Belle and I everywhere. I know she thinks he can keep her safe, but I know he can't. He's so full of himself. December 22nd. I think Grant's cat died during the tremors and the chaos. Good riddance. The guy's been sobbing for almost a day now. Maybe now Belle will understand that he's not fit to protect her. December 26th. What's his latest entry? Like, past everyone else. I think I'd die for Belle. December 26th. I think I'd die for Belle. It's pretty much been established that something's running around and killing people. I'm going to fight it when I see it. It'll only get to Belle over my dead body. She'll die knowing that I gave my life just to tack a couple of seconds onto hers. Yeah, is that the way it happened? I haven't found her body. Or the other girls. Well, these are all very interesting. Was there anything else in here? Evidently not. Anything else twinkling? No. Alright, I guess we're done in here. What items do I have? Just a, oh, I only have the drill. Kinda curious though.
No, that won't work.
It has to work, mister. Can I drill into the lockers and see what's in there?
No. Crazy.
That sounded weird right before I left. Probably just one of those random noises.
Maybe if it... No. No, that won't work.
I don't know. Let's... Just trying random stuff, like... What if I drill into these roots?
That's just crazy. Although...
It's like he reconsidered. Alright. So that's it for this section. So we have this elevator and we have the monitors. Well, we can't open this yet. Let me just take a look at the security panel though. Maybe we can get rid of the gas this way. Door locked to atmosphere. Control override. No. I can't click on these. Yeah, I don't think that's a good idea. So can we take this well, we can't open this.
No power to the elevator.
So... I want to shut that off, obviously. But there was no option to shut off the gas. So this must be where the gas is. Yep. Death. Okay, and that's the elevator where we were. I guess we haven't been here yet. Maybe this is the entertainment area? Atmosphere control access. You figured this was where it would be. I did look at this, right? Yeah. Should I try my luck with the gas? I'm not sure where else to go. Can't get it in there.
Looks like gas.
Gonna save here. Cause you know what I'm gonna do. Override lock and open door. It'd be nice if that shut off the gas as well, but it doesn't. It's not indicating that does so.
Wait, there's a highly corrosive gas on the other side of that door.
I know.
Shit, I've already cycled the lock.
John!
Atmosphere compromised. Death is in.
Now you tell me. Yeah, I had a feeling. All right. Make sure we load. All right, so maybe something I've missed in these areas. Sometimes he'll comment on things. Maybe give us a clue. Oh! This is a cyclical thing we can go through here. Alright.
That is a long way down.
Oh, I see. There is a hole in the floor. I thought it was like, my perspective was such that it was like, I thought it was a floor. Like, not a floor, like a, I don't know, a piece of metal laying on the floor. But no, I can see that's the light. It's the lighting. Makes it look that color. Right, he can't. So maybe if we take some of these roots, and the drill didn't work there, but maybe on this growth?
These don't go well together.
Give me that. All I have is this drill.
Maybe. No.
I think it's a great idea. Grab one of the roots. A profusion of gnarled growths has spread through the sleeping block like roots, covering every surface in the same manner as a choking vine. So I have something, I need a way to get him down there safely. Torn up floor grating, alright. I'll stop at the cigarettes. See if there's anything in here I missed. Oh, papers! I didn't see this. Countless abandoned photographs of families and loved ones are strewn across the floor. I can't do anything with that stuff. Really need a selectables key to highlight selectables. More papers. So when I've missed papers, maybe I've missed something useful. Somebody can't get in these personal lockers. He can't even get through to get over there. The quick message from the Cortex experience for breakdown. Please send a tech crew to security office 001. I heard that. Maybe if I mess with those trees. Maybe we don't want to mess with the, nasty roots, because they might attack us. Maybe we want to mess with the dead tree or the other stuff. Dead plants.
I don't know what I was thinking there.
We need stuff. Something. Alright, I'm gonna have to ruminate on this. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, where hopefully I make it somewhere. And, always, seek adventure.